New York Times column, Black People Can't Be Friends with White People. We're all aware of the race-baiting mainstream media, but apparently it's reaching new all-time lows after the New York Times just published a hit piece on why black people and white people can't be friends. That's right, apparently it's 1950 again, except this time, black people are segregating themselves. The left fully understands that in order to destroy this country, they must spread hatred and sow the seeds of division. A country divided amongst itself cannot stand on its own 2 feet to face the threats of ISIS, China, or any sort of domestic terrorist group such as Antifa. Consequently, leftist activist groups and liberal billionaires such as Soros are doing everything in their power to divide and conquer. They're convincing minorities that whites are evil and oppressive, and they're continually enacting violence against innocent Trump voters and conservatives. Apparently they've reached a new low, however, after E. Cowan Yanka published an article for the New York Times asking whether or not his children can be friends with white people. After much deliberation, the conclusion that he comes to is a hard no: his black children cannot be friends with white people. My oldest son, wrestling with a 4-year-old's happy struggles, is trying to clarify how many people can be his best friend. My best friends are you and Mama and my brother and, but even a child's joy is not immune to this ominous political period. This summer's images of violence in Charlottesville, Virginia, prompted an array of questions. Some people hate others because they are different, I offer, lamely. A childish but distinct panic enters his voice. But I'm not different. It is impossible to convey the mixture of heartbreak and fear I feel for him. Donald Trump's election has made it clear that I will teach my boys the lesson generations old, one that I for the most part nearly escaped. I will teach them to be cautious, I will teach them suspicion, and I will teach them distrust. Much sooner than I thought I would, I will have to discuss with my boys whether they can truly be friends with white people. History has provided little reason for people of color to trust white people in this way, and these recent months have put in the starkest relief the contempt with which the country measures the value of racial minorities. America is transfixed on the opiate epidemic among white Americans, who often get hooked after being overprescribed painkillers. While studies show that doctors underprescribe pain medication for African Americans. But when black lives were struck by addiction, we cordoned off minority communities with the police and threw away an entire generation of black and Hispanic men. Don't misunderstand, white Trump supporters and people of color can like one another. But real friendship? Mr. Trump's bruised ego invents outrageous claims of voter fraud, not caring that this rhetoric was built upon dogs in water hoses set on black children and even today the relentless effort to silence black voices. His macho talk about law and order does not keep communities safe and threatens the very bodies of the little boys I love. No amount of shoveled snow makes it all right, and too many imagine they can have it both ways. It is this desperation to reap the rewards of white power without being so much as indicted that James Baldwin recognized as America's criminal innocence. For African Americans, race has become a proxy not just for politics but also for decency. White faces are swept together, ominous anxiety behind every chance encounter at the airport or smiling white cashier. If they are not clearly allies, they will seem unsafe to me. So let's try to get this straight. Mr. Yanka thinks that whites cannot be friends with blacks, simply because they're white? Wow, that sounds a lot like racism, doesn't it? That thing that leftists are always claiming they're trying to fight. Apparently it's okay when they're racist against white people, though. Imagine what would happen if a white author for the New York Times wrote an article about how he won't let his children be friends with black kids. Do you know what would happen to him? CNN would air an entire 60 Minutes episode on him, and he would lose his entire life, job, and security. Yet for some reason, after nearly a decade of race baiting and identity politics by the left, it's okay for them to hate white people. This just goes to show you that they don't really give a damn about true equality. All they want is a moral high ground so that they can crush conservatives into the dirt, and get power for themselves.